Hello, chem students. So in this video, I'm going to just talk about some of the abilities for us to separate mixtures. That is an important technique. They're typically referred to as purification techniques. So in the example here, I have some nice, pretty precipitates. These precipitates come in different colors. They're not always as pretty, but for the most part, we can see that when we have an example of precipitates that are insoluble salts, they're typically referred to as heterogeneous mixtures. So heterogeneous mixtures are where you see two distinct layers. And a lot of times you can separate these by different means. One of the means is you could let the solid settle to the bottom. And if it settles to the bottom, you can then pour off the top liquid. So if you let the solid settle to the bottom, right, that's your precipitate, sometimes referred to as a pellet, and then the liquid on the top you can just pour off. And if you do that, that's referred to as decanting. And that liquid on the top is referred to as your supernatant. So you can decant your supernatant and leave your precipitate at the bottom. Now, a better way of doing that is actually have it go through centrifugation and spin it on a centrifuge. Then that way, that pellet is really solid, and when you decant, you won't get some of the solid pouring off. Okay, another way that's a little more efficient that people are familiar with is you can use filtration. So you can set up a gravity filtration, just have a funnel with filter paper in it, and just pour your mixture directly through. And what'll happen is the larger particles of the precipitate will stay in the filter, and the liquid, right, the liquid that it's mixed with, but not evenly, because again, this is a heterogeneous, there's distinct layer differences, they're not uniform. The liquid will go through the filter paper because there's a smaller component, and that's typically, that liquid is referred to as the filtrate. The filtrate goes through the filter paper, and then you have the suspension or the precipitate will stay in the filter paper and be trapped. Well, what if I have a homogeneous mixture? So instead of a heterogeneous, hetero means different. You see distinct layer differences. The particles are big. Homo means same. In the homogeneous mixture, the particles are evenly distributed, and they're inside the solvent in a way that they're so small, we can't see the difference. So a classical example of that might be salt water. So how would we separate a homogeneous mixture? Well, you can't use filtration because the salt ions are small enough, they'll go through with the filtrate. So what do? Distillation. So we can take advantage of the fact that this mixture has two different components. So we'll say salt water, right? And with salt, it has a much higher boiling point than liquid water. So I could take my salt water and put it in a distillation flask, and you see that it has its little distilling head, and I can have a condenser and a collection flasks. And what I can do is I can take advantage that water has a lower boiling point than the salt. If I heat up the water, it'll vaporize, recondense, and then I can collect it here. What'll happen is I'll end up purifying this and separating it based on its physical properties. So the water will collect here, and I'll leave the solid behind. Now, one of the things you never want to do in chemistry is have a closed, right, system and heat to dryness. So we would never heat this to dryness, okay? So if you want to boil off water and just have the salt stay behind, and let's say weigh your salt, you wouldn't cap this off like that. This is only if you wanted to collect the one component that was a liquid. Another example of this is you may have heard distillations, right? Whiskey distilled is if you want to make your ethanol a stronger, right, percentage. Well, you would distill the ethanol and capture your ethanol here, making it more pure and separating it from other components in the mixture. They also do this with fossil fuels, petroleum, right? Petroleum that comes out of the ground is not just gasoline ready to go. they distill it based on boiling points, and they can make kerosene, jet fuel, asphalt, plastics. But what they're doing is they're separating the mixture of petroleum by its physical properties, boiling points. So I hope that makes sense, that we'll be separating mixtures in lab and in general and in chemistry. And now you understand that with homogeneous mixtures, you'll be doing things like distillation. With the heterogeneous mixtures, where the particles are bigger, you'll probably use something as simple as filtration. Thanks for tuning in, and leave your comments below.